You're listening to When Christians Speak Online Talk Radio, broadcasting out of the Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. Today's voice crying out in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. When Christians Speak is dedicated to lifting up the name of Christ Jesus and spreading the good news. Speak Talk Radio is a non-profit ministry. We are dedicated to spreading the gospel of Jesus through our programs and special guests. We exist through the generous support of our listeners. If you are being blessed through this ministry and would like to give a love offering, go to our website and click on our donation page. Your donation will be processed through PayPal. Our prayer is that you may prosper, be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Unto the Lord, for he is
good. When Christians Speak Talk Radio is a 501c3 nonprofit ministry, so all of your gifts to this ministry are tax deductible. So go out to our website, www.whenchristianspeak.com, and click on our donation page. Oh, give thanks unto the
Challenge to change, where transformation begins with you. Change appears to be one of the biggest hindrances to growth from relationships that I have encountered while in ministry. Our focus is usually on someone else and what they have done or are doing to us, instead of us being accountable to God and making sure we're not a stumbling block to ourselves or others. Challenge to change is about us taking personal responsibility for our Christian walk as we face challenges and issues and how to overcome them through biblical tools and techniques that we will discuss on this show. Everything about this show is encompassed in us depending on the Holy Spirit to edify, enrich, and transform lives by introducing individuals to a personal encounter with God's unconditional love. That is where real transformation begins and ends.
So we've been talking about Let's go one more. Running man. How do we grow if we keep running from growth? So, she know I'm going to do it. Megan, she know I'm going to do it. So, I might as well do what she know I'm going to do. So, let's talk about what you're feeling now. That you did it up here. What are the thoughts that's running through your head now? Get a mic. Or you want them to tell you what you might be thinking. She says she wants you all to tell her what she might be thinking. What's going through her head. Who's going to do it? Raise your hand. Got one here, one here.
I feel like maybe she's thinking, that wasn't so bad after all. I should have done that a long time ago.
Okay. Is it in there anywhere? No? No, okay, okay. All right.
That's what I was going to say. I did it.
Okay. Okay, all right, okay. Okay, you sure? Okay. Who else?
I feel like going off of the teaching you said that when we're supposed to be, when we're in place where God wants us to be, then all the blessings will really come through.
Okay. Okay.
So I figured then I might as well get in place and line up with God.
You keep on talking, you're going to teach. Come on now. Woo-hoo-hoo. That's good. Good. What else? What else you think she's thinking?
So Faith doesn't particularly like people looking at her.
Okay.
So the idea that she's standing on the stage and everyone has to look at her, uh-huh. That might be a part of the equation.
Okay. That's in there? Okay. I got one in the back.
I think that she's thinking, okay, now, I done did this time. When I'm going to do it again? Or is somebody going to ask me to do it again?
Is it in there anywhere? Okay. All right.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Oh, it wasn't as bad. Okay. She said, yeah. Okay. Anybody else? Okay, got one?
She's thinking that, you know, hey, these people are really supporting me, you know?
You felt that? Okay. Okay. So how was last night? You know, knowing that you got to sing today. What were the thoughts for that?
I was a little nervous.
Okay. All right.
More so about my introduction and the prayer.
Okay, really? Okay.
Yes. Right.
Okay.
But last night I slept well.
Okay. All right. Yeah. I like how when you was finished praying, you stopped. Can you all tell when somebody add on stuff? But Lord, by the way, down by the wayside and the riverside and the boat and all that, she just stopped when she was finished. Okay. All right. So we just wanted to know what Faith was thinking. Okay. All right. So you guys remember what the Holy Spirit told you that you were running away from? Remember when we've been talking about this and everybody raised their hand? How many of you guys still remember? Okay. All right. It looked like the whole front row. What about second row? Third row? Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. You remember to us? You trying to remember, Nicole? Just ask him again. Just repent and say, Holy Spirit, I lost it on that one. All right. Finishing the race. So we're going to start on the five steps to finishing the race. How many did I say you needed? Oh, see, it was a test. How many remember Sunday? What'd I say? You only need one, but why did I add five? Overachievers. Okay. Are y'all in the house? Okay. How many scriptures do you need to get healed? I'm going to give you the answer right there. I did that. Just in case. Okay. All right. Five steps to finishing the race, but you only need one. What I'm finding out about believers, this is just me, you guys might not be like that, is that somewhere in the mindset it says that if God told us to do it, then it's supposed to be easy. How many people thought like that? Okay, all right. And so if we run into a situation, even loved ones stop loving us, are we supposed to finish what God called us to? We supposed to finish? So if a situation comes up that you didn't plan for, are you supposed to finish? Okay. So what stops us from finishing? I got one here. This is a roundabout review.
Okay, you mean anything? Mm-hmm. Like what's it? Fear of failure?
Fear of failure, okay. All right, what else? You might be talking about somebody else. Just because you answered, it might not be you.
Other people.
Other people. How about other people?
Other people passing their negative thoughts onto you.
Okay.
And you believe in them over what you know is to be true.
Okay. Do people know that they're being negative when they pass their thoughts on? Some say yes, some say no. How many say yes? Raise your hand. All right, let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. How many think that is innocent? 1, 2, 2. Okay, ignorant. Okay. What do you mean ignorance? Might come your way.
They just don't know any better.
They don't know any better. Okay. All right. Were you giving to say something, Cher?
Just won't practice it.
Ooh. Ooh. Wow. Okay. All right. All right. These are the five steps. I have so much confidence in the Lord that you can just pick one. But we're still going to go over all five. All right. Number one is count the cost. What do you guys think that means? Would you hear something? Go ahead.
Well, you asked about what stopped us.
Uh-huh, yes.
The fear of judgment.
Oh, what does that say?
They're afraid of someone. Well, I know me. I can only speak for me. I was afraid of how people would judge me, whether it was good or bad.
Okay. All right.
You know, so I would sometimes not make a decision or not do things because I was afraid of how people might think I looked according to them or their opinions.
Okay. All right.
But counting the cost means you have to weigh the options of what you're going to do.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. It's a little bit piggyback on what Faith just said, is that, like, you can there may not be people who are going to approve what you're doing on the way.
Okay.
And if, like, in my instance where I have such a fear of people disapproving me,
uh-huh,
I have to count the cost and say, okay, Wayne, you're going to have to get a thick skin.
Okay. Yeah. All right. How many of you guys had to get a thicker skin? Okay. Just about everybody. Okay.
I said this on Sunday, but it came up again when it comes to count the cost. And I think because this applies so much in my personal life, we're always so focused on, like, what's going to happen if I do, but we don't so much focus on what's going to miss out if we don't. Okay. It's like when I told you about how, like, we don't think about the people who are going to be missing out on our blessings that we could be given them okay. if we were obedient and followed through with the things we were supposed to be doing.
Okay. All right. Anybody else? So how do you feel when someone, the person who criticized you is not doing anything? All right, I'm looking at them. Jenny, how do you feel when that happened? Give Jenny the mic. She laughed. She almost rolled in the chair right there.
It's something simple, but it made me laugh. We had a situation last night where my husband, we had something with the dog food or something silly, okay. right? And he was telling me all this stuff I could do. And I was like, okay, so go ahead. you know, but it's just a more of a, you know, why do I have to do it? It can be a joint thing. Okay. It doesn't have to be me.
Okay, all right, good.
Usually when that happens, it's someone that's in my peer group, so I'll bring it to their attention. I'll tell them, hey, you might say that, but what did you do?
Okay.
No.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So you will confront it?
Yeah.
All right. What normally happens, guys? I mean, when everybody had it happen to them, right? More than once. So what do you do?
Well, it makes me want to cuss.
Okay. I appreciate your honesty.
Because my thing is, like, you're giving me advice or you're telling me something, but you're not doing it yourself.
Okay.
And so it's like, how dare you?
Okay.
You know, that's
okay.
just how
okay.
I
Okay. All right. So you want to cuss them? What else? Anybody else? Wayne?
It makes me lose respect for that person.
Okay. Yeah. But what I'm finding out is people hold it in instead of saying something. Why do you think that happens? That, okay, hand went up on that one. Scared of offending. Okay. So are you saying that the people who normally do this have some type of weight in your life? Okay. All right. I got two.
Because personally, I'm a person that does not like confrontation.
Okay.
And I'm not really good at it. You know, people who are good at confrontations are people who do it on a regular basis. But okay. just like, you know, I don't cuss.
Okay.
So I don't know how to, you know, I know a few curse words, gotcha. But okay. I don't know how to really curse somebody else because gotcha. I don't, okay. you know, I don't
okay.
do it.
Okay.
So therefore, I'm just saying that if somebody is accustomed to doing it all the time, you know, they can snap back
gotcha.
And, you
okay.
know, come at
okay.
you, but okay. I can't do it. So.
Gotcha. Okay.
That just makes me feel some kind of way.
Okay, appreciate your honesty. Ed?
Yeah, I used to cuss.
Okay, all right.
I could curse.
Okay, all
right. Like you used to do. But now, but now, it's, I just don't say.
Okay.
I just get quiet.
Okay.
And let them stew in what they're dealing with.
Okay.
And it's also kind of rewarding when they can't get the rise out of me that they would like.
Okay.
And I also know that if I let myself get upset, I can tell.
Okay, gotcha.
It's almost like, you know, I get flush and uh-huh. I know that when that happens to me, like it has from childhood up, I lose control.
Okay. All right.
And I don't trust myself when I lose control.
Okay. Appreciate Josh. Who is it? Yes.
So I think with me, I think I like with Ms. Sharon, like okay. I always wanted to cuss somebody out, but I never knew how to
okay,
do that.
All right.
So, but with me, it's more so like knowing somebody's profile. Uh-huh. And if you're telling me, critiquing me, but you're not doing it, I typically just nod my head like you're doing, okay. but I don't take the advice.
Got you. Okay. All right. So you filter through it.
Yes.
Okay. Shut up. I wish you stopped talking. Yeah. Okay. All right. Anybody else? Go ahead.
I think that you just have to weigh the options. Like, is this person intelligent enough to have an intelligent conversation with me about
okay.
that? Because if they're not, it's pointless and you're not going to get anywhere anyways.
Okay.
So I think the best thing to do is just prove them wrong by your actions and not your words.
Okay.
You can't make sense out of nonsense.
Okay, you can't do it.
No.
Okay.
So,
okay.
I mean, a lot of times for me, like, when somebody's telling me or critiquing me or whatever, I'm looking at their fruit.
Okay.
You know, But a lot of times I realize for some, it's to get the reaction out of me.
Okay.
So I just don't react. I shut gotcha. Down on them.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to ask an honest question. Will y'all give me an honest answer? I hear what y'all are saying, but how many of you all take it with you once the conversation is finished? All right. Y'all shut your eyes for a second. Because some of y'all are not being honest. Now, would you mind raising your hand again? How many of you all take it with you after, although you say you use this, you use that, you use such and such? All right. Appreciate your honesty. You can put your hands down. Thank you so much. Okay. All right. All right. So who's that really hurting? Me. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Understanding falling isn't failure. So I'm going to just go over the five right quick. Focusing 2% on the problem and 98% on the solution. How many of y'all run into some folk that don't want to do the 98% or any percent on the solution? Y'all run into that? I mean, how do you know what's going on? Go ahead, Megan. Megan did a half hand. How do you know what's going on? How do you know they still on the, I'm sorry, they still, yeah, they're not willing to focus on the solution. How do you know that?
Keep suggesting solutions, uh-huh. and they, at each suggestion, have a reason why it won't work.
Okay.
I'm done. Okay. That's fine.
Okay. All right. So, Megan, how many will you give before you say I'm done? Who said three? Your husband said
it's
three.
It's probably true. Yeah.
Okay.
Probably three.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
And then I'll either say, so you tell me the solution, or okay. I'll just say, okay.
Okay.
Well, then we're moving on.
Okay.
Because I'm not going to sit there and go down that trail with you.
Okay.
Just not doing it.
Okay, not doing it. Who else? Teresa, you want to say something? Go ahead.
I'm pretty much in line with what Megan said, too.
Okay. About three?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's it. I tune out.
Tune out. Okay. Jasmine?
I have a random question that deals with this.
Okay.
Like, what happens to those days where you're just grumpy? Like, you don't have a reason? Is that your hormones? Like, and you just, like, I won't say you're looking for a fight because okay. I've been redeemed from that. But, like, you just irritated okay. and you be snapping okay. and you're not tired.
Okay.
But it's just random. It's like,
okay.
But it only happens, like, once every 6 months or something
okay.
like that.
Praise God. Hallelujah. So you just woke up and decided to be mad. Because, see, you can't have an emotion without having a thought. You can't do it. So if you're grumpy, you had to have grumpy thoughts. Can y'all help me with some grumpy thoughts? What's some grumpy thoughts? Audrey, give me a grumpy thought. Not to say you're grumpy. I'm just calling on people today.
Grumpy thought.
What's a grumpy thought? She said she could give me.
I don't know. Grumpy thought, moody, getting on my nerves.
You're getting on my nerve? Okay. All right. Who else?
I'm going to respond to kind of what Jasmine was going to say.
Okay. All right. We'll come back to you.
Okay.
You just wake up in the morning like, of course, it would be raining because it always rains whenever I want to go outside and do something.
Okay. All right.
What they looking at me for?
Oh. Okay. Well, help me with some grumpy thoughts.
I ordered my food from the Chick-fil-A app before I left the house.
Okay.
Why am I at the restaurant is not ready?
Okay, all right, okay, all right. Grumpy thought number one. What else? Anybody else? Yes, sir.
I had one today, but nobody's talking to me.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, all right. Yeah.
I have a question. Okay, is that a grumpy thought or is that a truth?
That's causing you to be grumpy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. So I just asked, what are you telling yourself in order to be grumpy? So it could be true, just like what she said about the rain. It's raining outside, and she wants to go out. Yeah, so it could be a true thought, but it's creating grumpiness. So I'm choosing to focus on, so where is life in that? Think on things that are true, honest, just, pure, lovely, of good report, virtuous. Not in there. Okay. Now, am I saying that you can't have challenging days? But what are those days doing for you if you're rolling around in the mud? I mean, you know.
I was just going to mention that when it rained really hard today and all of my clothes got wet, okay. I thank the Lord for washing my car.
Okay.
I don't have to pay for a car wash.
She replaced the grumpy thought. Okay. All right, anybody else? Sharon?
I had a grumpy thought a couple, I guess it was a couple weeks ago. I went to the dentist and they didn't tell me what I wanted to hear. And everything they did tell me, it was just such a downer.
Okay.
That when I left, I was really emotionally in a not good place.
Okay.
And I knew that I wasn't. But I came to my senses.
Okay.
When the scripture came to me, why you cast down, soul? Hope in God, you know? Where's your hope, girl?
Okay.
So I had to talk myself out of that because I was in a place where I didn't even like the way I was feeling.
Okay.
And it did lift my spirits.
Okay, amen. So I'm going to ask you to do something. I want you to ask yourself out loud when it happens, when the grumpy thought happens, ask yourself, well, how long do I want to stay here? But you can't ask it in your mind. What's your name? I've seen you before. Tiffany. So, Tiffany, I want you to ask out loud, not in your head. So, how long do I want to stay here? Because you get to determine how long you stay there. You can stay grumpy or angry or upset or whatever emotion you want to use. But if you ask yourself how long you want to stay there, then the answer comes back. It'll say, as long as you want. That's what it normally happens. Or most people don't get a hour or day. It comes back because all of you guys are in the Lord. So it comes back. What'd I say? To what? I just gave you the answer. What does it say back to you? When you as long as you want. That's how it's going to come back. But I want you to ask it out loud so you can hear it. You will hear your voice through the Holy Spirit say it for as long as you want. Okay, Audrey, you had a question or a statement?
Yeah, I just have a statement. Because if you do get grumpy, it just keeps going on.
Uh-huh.
Unless you stop it.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you say stop the thought.
Mm-hmm.
Or change your perspective or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of keeps like a domino effect. It goes from one thing to the one thing. Sometimes it goes from one thing to the other. It has nothing related to do with what you started out.
Mm-hmm. Because it has to grab the things that it thinks will cause you to stay where you are. Because that's the directive that it thinks you want it to have. Yes, sir.
Sometimes with me, when I ask that question, it's almost like I want to vent.
And you want to vent?
Okay. Yeah. But once I vent, I don't know what I want to happen. But I want something to happen.
Okay.
So how long I want to be angry.
Okay.
Most of the time, I don't want to be angry anymore. But I just want to vent to somebody and something to happen.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So you're looking to find somebody to vent to. Anybody ever look for somebody to find to vent? Yeah? Do y'all go to a close friend or just anybody y'all can find? Huh? Whoever's in the car? Keep it in the car. Oh. Okay, car is empty. Okay, she said keep it in the car. The car is empty. Okay.
Sometimes I feel like I just want my mama to smack me upside the head and just, like, hug me. Like, you know, some days you just need that.
Okay, just smack and hug.
Yeah.
All right, girl, you got permission.
I don't like it when she'll leave me alone. She'll be like, okay, you're having a moment. Or sometimes she even hangs up on me, and then I'll call her back, and I'm like, I know you didn't hang up on me. But that was her way of trying to set a boundary. But I'm like, uh-uh. Like, no.
Okay. What did you say, smack me or love me? Honey, you got permission then, but it's pretty cool. Yes, sir. Anybody else? Everybody cool? All right. Remember the power. I mentioned that on Sunday. That was revelation for me. I hadn't seen a scripture like that before. Remember the power. And I'll go over that when we get to it. And just do it. Nike didn't come up with that. Jesus did. God the Father did. Okay? All right. Step number one. Who going to read? Monty, you got the mic.
Is there anyone here who, planning to build a new house, doesn't first sit down and figure the cost so you'll know if you can complete it?
Can we put... For the sake of scripture, can we put something else in there? Planning to go to school, planning to go to college, planning to buy a car, planning to get a house, planning to get dental work done. What else can we put in there? Because I want to make it relevant to you. Now, for those who remember what the Holy Spirit showed you, can Anybody feel comfortable sharing what he showed you that he wanted you to focus on doing this teaching for the last 6 weeks? Anybody feel comfortable sharing what it was? Okay, nobody? All right. So, what, somebody give me say something? First, sit down. So what that means is stop everything that you're doing and let's have a conversation. Me, you, and the Holy Spirit. I mean, if I'm doing it, I'm talking to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, you know, it's like, you want me to do what? And now, so where am I going to fit this in? What is it going to cost me? And look at cost not only as financial, because it might not be a house, or it might not be a car, or it might not be something that you have to purchase, but it might be time. What are the things that we got to count the cost for? Of. So I just told you time, money, what else? Okay, give me a mic.
I don't know, that's what came to me, a relationship, because you have to, how much do you want to invest in a relationship? How much time do you want to spend?
Okay.
Where do you want to see this going?
Okay.
And how much of you will you have to give toward this relationship?
Oh, okay. All right. So instead of house, we would put relationship there? Is that what I'm hearing? Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So how much will I have to give up of myself? How much time would this relationship cost? What else about relationship? Let's stay on relationship.
Yeah, it's on relationship.
Okay. See, you never know which
can
way
it,
they come.
I know, right? Can it work the opposite?
Which way?
Like, she's talking about getting in a relationship. How about getting out of a relationship?
Oh, okay. Let's go that way then.
Okay.
All right. So what's the cost of that?
My freedom.
Oh, okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Okay. I think that's all you need.
Yeah, that's all I really want. Okay.
That was it. That was it. Yes, sir.
Financial, if you have kids involved.
Oh, okay. Okay, what's the financial cost? Okay, all right. Megan?
I was just thinking, in Faith's example, wouldn't counting the cost be what she's planning for is her freedom.
Uh-huh.
The cost is ending the relationship.
Yeah. Okay, right? All right.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
So another form of cost could be your energy.
Ooh, what do you mean?
So, like, when you're working on a bunch of things at the same time and people are asking you to do something, uh-huh, you have to think about how much energy it's going to take to do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Shell, is that a hint or something? Okay. go ahead.
People who are doing this right now because they're planning on having a baby.
Okay. All right.
And so they really have to count the cost. So, okay, if, you know, when she's not working anymore and, you know, getting a bigger house and saving up in the meantime for when she's not working and where are they going to put the baby, okay, and how much it costs to have the baby, all that stuff.
Okay. So what else with the baby?
Your time.
Time.
Your life. Okay. Your everything.
Right. Okay. Huh? Yeah. Your what? Your marriage?
Your okay. sanity?
Your body? Okay. Okay. All right. So guys, if you grab this, the concept, Jesus always asks questions in order to locate people. The enemy wants you all not to ask questions to get clarity on stuff. Whatever situation I find myself in, I'm going to ask myself a question. And if you accuse me of having a good attitude, it's because I'm asking myself the question that will take me there, according to thinking on those things that are true, honest, just, pure, lovely, of good report. I can be as funky as you want to be, but funky don't work for me because it doesn't give me peace. So if you're doing something that you don't like doing, ask yourself, how long will it take before this is over? How can I do this and enjoy what I'm doing? Now, the spirit on the inside of you wants to answer the question, but you got to ask them. Remember how I said about cutting grass? I always get music that I haven't heard before, and I cut the grass to that. If I'm working on something, I always ask myself, What can I do? How can I do this and enjoy the process? And it might come back and say, do 5-minute increments. I like 20 minutes, but if it's saying 5 minutes, it must be intense. But in 5 minutes, I say, all I got to do is for 5 minutes, then I get a break. Then you come back in 5 more minutes and get a break. Some of you achievers thinking, man, that's going to take a long time. But the attitude was good while I was doing it. We are going to be faced with situations we don't like. But we got to ask ourselves the right question so the Holy Spirit can help us. Say, help us. Help us. Okay? Somebody hit the mic. Okay, Wayne?
I was going to say, you give up a level of control in your life of certain things? Because if God's telling you to do something, you may not know where it is, how to go about doing it.
Okay.
And for someone who wants to know everything in advance, that can be really frightening.
Okay, all right. Okay, appreciate your honesty. Cheryl?
You said counting the cost of getting out of a relationship.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes it's social standing.
Okay, what do you mean? Ooh.
If you're in one of those circles where it's couples and couples, and you always going somewhere with other couples, getting out of that relationship means you're no longer a couple.
Okay, gotcha.
So you're going to have to find a new circle of people to hang around with who aren't so coupled.
Okay, all right, appreciate that. So who's responsible for telling the people that we're not a couple anymore? See. You didn't think about that long at all. So what I'm trying to do is go the questions that you're not asking. Follow me? What did you say?
You said something about Jesus asks questions to locate, but the enemy doesn't want us to ask questions.
No. He asks us questions to locate where we are. Okay. So, you know, with one guy, he walked up to him, and it's obvious he was blind. It was a blind man. And he said, what will you that I should do for you? And to all of us, we're in the sidelines, you know, we're in the sidelines thinking, see. But maybe that's not what he wanted. You know what I'm saying? So I learned questions from him that is like, why would he ask a question about this? Why? Because he wanted to find out what people really wanted. Yeah. All right? So you need to ask yourself questions to find out, what do you really want? Do you want to stay in this situation or do you want to get out of it? I mean, we get in financial trouble because we refuse to ask ourselves a question. Can you afford this? Is this the right time to buy it? Is it on sale? Have I saved for it? What would it cost me when I don't pay? What else? We don't ask about finances. Can I wait? Am I going to like the consequences? Will I have to do more maintenance on this than I thought? What would Dave Ramsey say? What else? We don't ask about money. Will I enjoy it after I buy it? Okay. Ooh. Okay, and the answer is no. Is there interest on it? Okay. See how we can ask questions? Have you asked a question? I want you guys to write this one down. Y'all ready for it? It's easy. Who will I lose if I step into this arena? Because, guys, I've seen more people lose people close to them when they grow. That's why I'm asking you to ask the question. Who will I lose if I grow? Who will I lose if I go back to college? Who will I lose if I accept this job? Who will I lose if I finish the sentence? Grow. Because not everybody's excited for you to grow, including family. So that's a real question I want you to ask. Who will I lose if I plan to build this new house, new car? Well, of course you don't build a new car, but anyway, y'all get the point, right? If I advance, if I grow. How many of you all were surprised by who you lost when you grew? Can I get a couple hands? A quick testimony on it? You want to go for it? Go ahead.
Kind of weird. I just had this conversation with a friend today. We were talking about how, like, in relationships, sometimes you're in a relationship with somebody and you grow way beyond that person. And then actually what we talked about today was how both of us were in the same situation where that person fell off.
Okay.
Then all of a sudden, they're, like, almost against what you're doing. Then there's, like, this, like, power struggle type thing. But then it's weird how that person seems to be doing really bad
okay.
in every area of their life. And then they almost resent you for growing.
Okay.
And then you guys just don't see eye to eye anymore. And then you do, you lose a lot of people who are almost like jealous of like how happy you are
okay.
and like the things that you're doing in life. Okay. So that's how you lose a lot of people when you grow.
Okay. All right. In the back.
I lost a couple of people at work okay. based on the position I got.
Okay.
I mean, they pretty much don't want to hang with me no more.
Okay.
So it's more of an authority figure.
Okay.
Just, yeah.
Were you surprised?
I was actually, because when I was with them, it was all shucking and jabbing, joking, okay. and as soon as I had another position, it was like a barrier, distance okay. between us.
Okay. How many of you guys lost people because you got promoted? Okay. Yeah. Did anybody ever want to talk about it, or they just, no? Passive aggressive? Okay. If you ask them what's going on, what happened, they'll just say, oh, we cool, what you're asking about. So they made you look like you had an issue. Okay. All right. All right. Figure the call so you know if you can complete it. So I want us to plan more about our life, where it's going. Plan just means you're going to ask some questions. You're going to ask some questions. Now, everybody has this one friend. One friend that you know if you go to them, they will give you honest advice. You know what I mean? So when you're counting the cost and you and the Holy Spirit already talk, this person is the person that will talk to you freely but has no interest other than to see you succeed. Everybody need at least one of those. Meaning that, wait a minute, Faith. You know, based off where you told me your bills were, what if we postpone this until we get the finances straight in that area? You follow me? So they not raining on your parade. You got to make sure you got that one friend. Because if you don't have that, then don't go to Billy Bob and Sally that like I said, that you can tell they don't have no fruit. I don't know what it is about them sometimes that we run to. Why we run to somebody that doesn't have fruit? What is it about us about that? Got to go.
They don't have to hold you accountable for what you do.
Whoa. No, you got to talk to me.
Because people tend to choose people that don't allow them to grow.
Uh-huh.
Because then there's no risk
okay.
in it.
Ooh.
They can do whatever they want.
Okay. Wow. She told y'all, did she? Okay. Yes, sir.
So they will tell you what you want them to tell you.
Okay. All right. And how can you tell?
That's all. They just agree with everything you say.
Okay. All right. Okay. So they want you to go in debt. They want you to fail. But it's cool because it looked like they paying attention to you what you said you wanted and so forth.
Misery loves company.
Okay. All right. If you only get the foundation laid, then run out of money, or what else can we put there? Time, resources, what else? Patience. What is that? Energy. You're going to look pretty foolish. Why would you look foolish? You didn't count the cost. And everyone passing by. Because how many of us know that when we're about to do something, we share it with people? And so they looking for us to do what? So they're going to pass by. In fact, they'll call you up. Hey, so how's school going? What grade are you in? Are you about to graduate? And then you got to tell them what? I had to sit out a semester. And one semester equal how many? Two. And two equal what? Everyone passing by will poke fun at you. Will they do it to your face, or how they do it? Behind your back. What do you mean? So give me a behind your back scenario. That they just make sure you get to hear it, right?
Like if somebody bad mouths you to a friend that they know that you hang out with. Uh-huh. Like clearly my friend's going to tell me that you said something.
Yeah.
You're real dumb.
Okay. How hard is it to tell people you don't want to hear it? Okay. Anybody did that? where you told somebody, I know where this is going. I don't want to hear it. You have, Shea, what took you to that place?
It's tiresome.
Okay.
It's like, okay, fine. They said something.
Okay.
Just because somebody says something don't mean you got to tell me about it.
Okay.
I'm good. Right. Okay. I know what they think about me. Okay. We can stop now. Thank you. Okay.
Because when we hear what we do? Get mad. Get mad? You go there?
Yeah. Talk smack.
Talk smack? Okay. Talk? Come front? Uh-oh.
Sometimes it's juicy. I just want to hear more.
Huh? What?
Yeah. Sometimes people talk about people, and I'm guilty of it.
Okay.
They come gossiping. I'm like, what'd he say? I want to know.
Okay.
I just want to know.
Brother Lisa, he clear. He clear. Thank you, sir. Meg?
I was thinking the opposite. I was thinking it's none of my business what you think about me.
Okay. Okay. All right. So you tell him stop?
Sometimes, right? Okay. I'm like, that's okay. Okay. I don't need to know that.
Okay.
How's it going to help me?
It's not going to help. All right. Wait.
I'd love to hear with Madeline because, in a way, I kind of agree with Top Gun.
Okay.
Because I want to know who my enemies are.
Okay. Ooh.
You know, okay. I want to know who's for me or who's against me.
Okay. All right. Okay. Appreciate your honesty.
I like to know what they're saying because I like to prove them wrong.
Oh, ooh. Okay. Okay.
When I went to massage school.
Okay.
Because I was still working a full-time job and going to school full-time. And there's a lot of people I worked with. They're like, there's no way he's going to make it through school.
Okay.
So I finished tops in my class.
Okay, there you go. All right. Okay, you heard that, didn't you? He started something he couldn't finish. How many people are watching for us not to finish? And what you don't want to get is you don't want to get a reputation for not finishing. Because, see, what happens, this is what happens psychologically. Labeling is one of the most challenging cognitive distortions to overcome, the way you think. When you get to a place, what happens is the brain decides to put a groove in it, like a stronghold, and it says, this is just like last time. Quit. And it's challenging to overcome because you don't recognize that you're doing it. You know, when as Curly and I, you know, she's a Mary Kay director, and there are events sometimes where husbands are there, and I can look at the husband, how he talks about the business, the Mary Kay business, and I can tell that he's pretty ticked off, okay? Because in order to be as a salesperson, you got to have what? Sales. You got to have stuff to sell. So when, you know, we sit down and what normally happens is the wives, they'll go talking. And then the husband will be together. And I listen to how the husbands talk. And I'm looking at counting the calls. Because I'm thinking to myself, I can tell that this wife has been into something 5 or 6 times. And she quits. And the husband is upset about how the finance situation, you know, it's like she has these things and she didn't sell it. She quit this. So when will she quit this? You encountered that, honey? Absolutely. So that person is married, but the husband also has a scratch on his disc that says, what else is my wife going to quit? And I haven't been in things where men sold. So I'm sure wives go through the same thing. Follow me? So I just want to make sure I'm balanced. Yeah, y'all got it? Okay. No stone in the past. No stone in the past. But the label goes in subconsciously, and then you start to do it. And what happens is, let's say if you're a cyclist and you quit everything. What happens is you're riding, and you say you get in on your bike, and you say, I'm going to do 30 miles today. And around you start to get the thought when. Just a rough. Huh? 10 miles. So 10 miles goes, okay, your ankle feeling a little funny. You sure you ate enough this morning? See, it won't come and say quit, right? What would it come and say? It's probably going to rain, okay? Ailments. Huh? This hurts. That hurts. And that's how quit comes. So it's labeled, but But each time it'll come different. It won't come the same way, but it labels itself. You know, if somebody calls you stupid, somebody can call you stupid as a two-year-old little boy, and you can live the rest of your life hearing that label, stupid. You can get as many degrees as you want, but it still has the label that says what? So I'm just saying, whatever you do consistently, you want to make sure that that's not one of them. Follow me? You can cut the grass and cut half the grass. And you say, I used to do that till I got here. Yeah, because my dad said I wasn't good enough. Well, the hammer out of my hand as I was nailing one day, and I was about 8, 9 years old. I saw my two other brothers nailing, and I go to grab it, you know, the hammer and nail, start nailing, and he took the hammer out of my hand. Well, what was he trying to do? Protect me from hitting my thumb. But I didn't know that. So what went in me was, you can start something, but you don't have to finish. And I didn't even know I was doing it until Curly brought it to my attention. She said, honey, honey, is there a reason why? Is there a reason? Ask questions at Logan. Is there a reason why you cut the front grass and check this out though, Megan? 3/4 of the backyard? So how close was I to finishing, Nicole? But I would do it every time, but it would just be a different part of the yard. I even tried, because I didn't know why I was doing it. So I would start in the backyard and cut the backyard 3/4 of the front yard. And always said, you know, I finish it tomorrow. Then when, you know, 2 weeks later, it's time to cut the grass, you got this much on this side. So I only teach what I've experienced. I only teach what I know. You won't hear me teaching about stock market and all that. I don't know nothing about that. That's where Curly come in. But you just got to just make sure that label don't come true in your life. Because it took counseling for me to find out what that was. Go ahead.
I think that, like, I've seen just recently how it affects how other people view you in a way of my sister and, well, both my brother and my sister, they both have been to school, like college, like 5 times and never finished. Okay. And, like, that's a fact. Like, they've been, like, 5 different times, 5 different schools and never finished. So recently my sister was talking about going back to school. Well, my dad was like,
Okay.
And then my sister was like, and even I was thinking, like, yeah, okay. Yeah. And then I had to catch myself because I'm like, I should be trying to encourage her, you know. And then she, you know, told my mom, she's like, man, you know, it really sucks. Like, I'm actually trying to do something. And dad's over here, you know, making me feel like I shouldn't even try. Yeah. And so then, you know, my mom had to talk to my dad about it. And I was thinking, wow, I mean, that's what happens when, you know, you always start something, don't finish. People start to expect that from you to the point where, like, you wonder why that person keeps on doing it when everybody around them keeps making it worse, you know?
And there are legitimate reasons for stopping something. Don't get me wrong. There are legitimate reasons. But you don't want to get labeled that. You don't want to get labeled in any capacity, to be totally honest with you. Wherever there's a label, you live up to it. You live out of it. Somebody else had the mic. Yes, Michelle?
Okay, suppose you had a label.
Okay.
It was, you had it. You lived it.
Okay.
But you've grown now.
Okay, all right.
And you'd like that label to drop off.
Okay.
You would like the people to stop seeing you based on how you were.
Okay.
And come up to where you now are.
Okay.
What you do?
You stop looking at them. You don't tell them your dreams. Okay. You don't tell them your aspirations. Mm-hmm. Only thing they know is what they see when they see it. Okay. Really? I'm serious. You know, when Curly and I, we bought our first car, we was excited about it. Nobody in our family had bought a new car. We bought a new car, so we decided we're going to share it with family. Family gives us a hard time, Nicole. We take one family member for a ride. First thing out of their mouth was, well, I know the insurance going to be more than the car. I looked in the rearview mirror because I was going to slam on brakes and put them out. But I was nice enough to drive them right back to the parking lot. So what ended up happening was when we got our first house, we didn't tell family. Family didn't know anything about our new house. We invited everybody over, and the family just happened to be in that number. And we had to give them an address. And they walking up, and they saying, whose house is this? Where's ours? Well, what do you think family said? Well, why didn't you tell me? And he say nothing. I just flip the burger. No need to say it because this is your new lifestyle. This is your new norm. You follow me? When it came time to minister, I had to minister at a funeral. My family didn't know I was at the time I was a reverend. And so, you know, like at certain churches, traditional Baptist churches, I know for sure, you walk down as a pastoral line behind the coffin, or you walk in front of, which one is it? Because different ones have different ways. Yeah, so walking in front of them. And that's when they found out that I was in ministry. You know, I could see them. They were like, what are you doing with them? And that's my guideline. That's my rule. I've shared with you guys about three times. After three times, we don't go back to revisit stuff. That's just where it is. So even to this day, follow me? I mean, I don't like pain. Y'all hear me say that all the time. If Jesus hung on the cross and he took the pain, then I'm always look towards him when pain come up. You follow me? All right. Anyway, people are looking to see where you're going to finish it or not. Little kids. Megan and I, we do a Jobs for Life program, international job training program. And when we have graduation, you'll be amazed at how many little children are in the audience and their Uncle Billy or Uncle Sally, I mean Aunt Sally, will say, you know, be so excited for them. And, you know, people will try to quiet them. We say, no, let them celebrate. And they'll come up afterwards and hug. And we'll say, so what happened here? And they say, well, this is my first time finishing something. And I wanted my niece or my nephew to see this. So people watch you guys. All right, so you're going to count the cost? How many of you guys got to count the cost on what you are working on right now? Okay, all right. Number two, we'll stop with this one. For right now, understanding falling isn't failure. Because what people think? What do we think? If you fall, then I must have failed. But did you learn anything while you was down there? Did you? What'd you learn while you were down there? It hurt. Okay, all right, it hurt. Okay, not to do it again.
I was just going to say, I think sometimes when people, instead of saying I failed, they think I'm a failure.
Okay.
Not what they did was a failure, that they are a failure.
Okay, right. Mm-hmm. That's called shame. I didn't make a mistake. I am the mistake. So let's read it. For a righteous man, that's who are we? Who made us righteous? So did our behavior make us righteous? Who made us righteous? So I'm in that category whether I feel like it or not. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor. I'm your neighbor. Neighbor. You righteous, man. All right. Now ask them, do they feel like the righteous? Do you feel like the righteous? I do now. Okay. What your neighbor say? Any neighbor said no? Okay. All right. Okay. But guess what? Just because you don't feel like it still doesn't stop it from being true. For a righteous man falls how many times? So you got seven times to get it right. I mean, do you need more than that? You do? I don't know. I'm being honest with you. I don't know. She said, is it a lifetime? Is it 7 days? I just know by the time you get up on the seventh time, you should be straight. Okay? Counsel with the Holy Spirit. But this is awesome right here. But they rise again. That means you're supposed to get up, guys. You're not supposed to stay there. You are supposed to get up. Because if I stay down there, what I got? Nothing. I got what's down there. But the wicked stumble in time of disaster and what? Doesn't say anything about them getting back up. So for those who think wickedness is a free run and you get to do whatever you want and you won't have to pay the consequence, I don't see it in Scripture. Maybe not this one. But it says right there they collapse. They stumble and collapse. And that word stumble means happenings. You know what I mean? It's like they can appear as if things are going well for them and they got it going on. Because it even talks about in Proverbs how it appears as if they get away with everything. Okay? Oh, I stopped. All right. So y'all got it? So how many times I got to get it right? Okay. All right. And it's up to you whether you're going to use all seven or not. Because some people like to stretch the sucker. They're like, okay. You know, when you're running late, it's like, I'm going to run through there and get there right at 9 o'clock. But a righteous man, they show up 7 minutes before. Can we do it? Okay, all right. All right, any questions? Everybody good? Y'all got some serious smirks on your face. Nicole?
This may sound odd, but if you, as a righteous person, connect, this is more so in business. If you connect with somebody who is not righteous, does that hold up or delay, or could that negatively impact you? I'm not saying like a partner, but if I hire somebody, I just had a recent situation and just made me think about Abraham and Lot. Like if you take somebody with you and the blessing is on you, does it stop?
So take us through the scenario. Take us through the real thing. So what was it about this person?
Okay, so I didn't feel a piece about
Y'all listen, okay? Because y'all going to answer. Okay, Nicole.
Everything that they had, their background check came back. Nothing was on there. They had all the experience, but it just something didn't feel right.
Okay.
Then you ministered last Thursday, I think, that we were going to be aware of our dreams. And I don't remember my dreams hardly ever. Had a bad dream about business.
Okay.
The next day, I got an email from the person resigning, and they've only been with me for 3 days.
Okay.
So I was upset, but then when I was talking to another Christian, she was like, you should be excited because maybe that person would have held you up from receiving what it is God. But for me, it felt like something spiritual. Okay. Like this person could be into something that was just like, contrary to everybody else on the team is a Christian, and I just didn't know if that could hold you up.
Okay, so there are some times where we want to bless people in a position they're in, and we feel like we are the person to help do that. That's different. What you shared was, what did she share that stood out to you guys? Give me a mic.
There's something in her spirit that didn't feel, that sit right. She wanted peace about hiring him.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Nicole, you have hired other people that were not Christians, correct? Okay. Okay. But you didn't get that same feeling with that. Okay. So what did she, what was going on, people? I got one here. I got one in the back.
Sounds like spiritual warfare. Okay. Like whatever that spirit that person had on them did not sit right in her spirit.
Okay. All right.
Discernment.
Okay, what do you mean?
She was discerning. Okay. She may not have realized it, but she was discerning.
Okay.
Because she knew that something was wrong.
Okay, all right.
But she was trying to not accept it.
Okay, all right. So Nicole, why do you think you didn't want to accept it? Might come your way. You can go ahead.
Yeah. It seemed more like discernment because everything looked right.
Okay.
Ooh. But still, something she felt that was wrong.
Okay. All right.
So all the things he was saying lined up with what it is I believe, why it is I believe I started the company. So he was like, you know, my child is going into high school. I just want to earn extra money to help and prepare for that.
Okay.
And I was like, this is a father. Okay. In my mind, he was a single father. He was doing this thing and all. I was like, I want to be helpful to that.
Okay, got you. Okay. All right. What else? Anybody else? Got one here?
But in all that, it seemed like she didn't have peace.
Okay.
About it. But even though she wanted to help, there was not peace there.
Okay.
So God is not the one who does not bring peace. He brings peace. Even though you were looking at the situation, there was no peace there.
Okay. So when you had the dream, was that it was about work? Or And can you tell us a little bit about that?
I don't really remember all the details, but I only had two guys that were working for me. So it seemed like it was another guy who works for me. But I couldn't, it was something negative. It was like they were being attacked.
Gotcha. Okay.
In a specific one of our buildings.
Okay. Okay. So you guys write this down. And so the intensity of the dream is unfinished business. Okay. So you guys can write that down. So the intensity of a dream is unfinished business. So the natural man tried to get your attention with what you felt. And I mean natural because you felt something. But the spiritual man says, I can't get to her, so let's try this avenue. And any of you guys had to do something, was working on something and didn't get finished, and it wasn't coming together the way you wanted to, and you kind of like dreamed about it. You know, it's like you woke up tired because you were still doing it. The spiritual man couldn't get your attention, so he says, this is when they normally have that blank slate, so let me write on that. But good question. So we you answered it. We just helped you. So remember something, guys, that a lot of times, let's see how I want to say this. If we know people spirit to spirit, then what happens is if we are a helper, people will gravitate towards us because they know we'll help. You follow me? One of the things Carolyn shared with me years ago when I was doing wedding photography, she said, Paul, the reason you do a contract is because a contract protects you and them. She said, never change the contract because that person is gravitating towards you to change something, so you will have to go through some challenges. You follow what I'm saying? Yeah. Okay.
This concludes today's message on Challenge to Change, where real transformation begins with you, with Pastor Paul Morgan. If you are ever in the Richmond, Virginia area, join Pastor Paul for Sunday service at 10 a.m. at Chosen Generation Ministries. The website is www.chosenrva.com or call at 866-333-9505.